All right, folks, before we get started tonight, I just want to report on some late-breaking news. I mean, late-breaking news. As it turns out, Diddy has been arrested. That's right. Diddy was caught in New York City just a few hours ago. So, you know what that means. Yep, that's right. The planet is now Diddy-free. Let's get on with tonight's episode of Week Now Update. And, by the way, Week Now Update is now officially drama-free. Let's get this over with, shall we?
Okay, all right. Okay, guys, let's review checklist. The Color Beanie Crew, check. Tom Allen, check. Edward Scott, check. Rebel Wilson, check. All right, we're all ready for the show tonight. All right, everybody, places, everybody. Ellie, you are on in 20 seconds. 20 seconds? Oh, we better go. Yeah, come on. Oh, we better do this. Yeah. Oh, man. I'm so excited. Best of luck, my schmoochie poo. Oh, thanks, the camel lady. All right, 15 seconds. Oh, I better do the intro for the camel lady. I better absolutely do another thing. I better do the intro of the introduction of the show. 10 seconds. Okay, it's just me. Yep. You really gotta impress the audience. Mm-hmm. All right, we're live in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and action! Hola, amigos. What's coming up next? It's Weeknight Update with Ellie Mueller. Then the morning show starring Rebel Wilson and Extremely Early with Edward Scott. That's all still to come on Nick at Night. Adios.
I'm the gorgeous
YouTube dog show. And by the way, James Gordon, please stay away from us. We don't need you over here. It's Week Now Update with Ellie Mueller. And now, man who thinks that James Gordon is nothing but a duck meat. Well, actually, I think he is a big nut job, but let's not go down that direction. At least not yet, anyway. Wait, what am I saying? Oh, boy, here he is, Mr. Ellie Gungy Mueller.
Update. I'm Ellie Gungy Mueller, one of the Grass Hawkers. Come out of Mike! I'm Alan!
Hey, boss, what's up?
Nothing much. Tom, what's up with you?
I'm having some problems with my wife.
Oh, I see. Are you having problems communicating and things like that?
Yes, yes!
You know, communication is important when it comes to having a relationship, but lately, she and I haven't been on the same page.
Don't worry. Calm down. Talking's over. You know, relax, and everything will be all right.
Oh, okay. Thanks, boss.
You got it.
All right. The theme song was composed by Dominic Mathis, piano, of course. The Camel Lady, the Color Beanie Crew, and E. Ramsey, Dragon Ball Love 2004 are responsible for most of the things that you will see in here on this program tonight. And they are Star Wars, Charles Black Wars tonight, along with Never Have Nine, The Barkers, The Barber Academy Show, Barber Academy, YL Alice is back, The 11 Podcast, The Endor, Marvel Maniac, Dark Lord Studios, Cassie Dragon, Silver Dragon, Origin, Supermaster Gyro, The Dark Emperor. Hey, you know what time it is, right? That's right. What's up?
What is up? What is up? What is up? What is up? What is up? What is up? What is up? What is up? What is up? Bum-bum-bum-bum.
Alright, what's up with James Corden? A man who used to be like, what happened? Ask every restaurant in the USA. Now, he said that Rick Ross was his worst talk show guest ever. Wait, that was rude. At least he was able to get guests. He should be lucky. I mean, I can't even get the celebrity guests on this program. Actually, don't think, but ever since the major exodus of 2022, I can't even get the regular guests over here. Excuse me. Oh, boy, I really need to stop sneezing during the show. Man! Hey, listen up! Lily Allen called him a bad friend. That is someone who wants to have sex with someone who will never give that person a chance. Yeah, that's a Me Too moment right there. That is a Me Too moment. Am I right? Huh? Alright, folks. It's time for another top 8 list. MP, Craigers, if you're ready, then let's go.
Does everybody know what time it is? Is it time for something that involves a weeknight update? That's correct. It's time for our top 8. Yeah, top 8 to know what the top 8 things are. Yeah, it's going to be great. Oh, I'm so excited. I wonder what the top 8 is going to be this time. Well, we're going to have to figure it out. Well, Ellie's going to figure it out. Yeah, Tom, it's absolutely so. Well then, what are we waiting for? Take it away, Ellie! Yeehaw!
You got it, boss. Science category, top 8 words that we can call James Corden. Number 8, Loopy. Number 7, Dorky. Number 6, Confused. Number 5, Wow. Number 4, Horrible. Number 3, Woo. Number 2, Jerky. And number 1, Wool. Do we need to say anything else? No, we do not. Boy, thank you very much. Thank you very much. You know what, bro? Hashtag we pop that. Hashtag Governor Flynn. Hashtag Governor for Donald Trump. Hashtag for LeBron. Hashtag Autism Move. You know what to do with those hashtags, right? All right, cool. All right, like, please subscribe, big bro, share it, and tell us in the comment section down below. Boy, oh boy, it's time for a couple of commercials. But after these commercials are done, we will return with more Week 9 Ads. Excuse me, Edward Scott and Special Delivery and the Motor Residence Book Bar and a moment for everyone and the all important talking time. Plus, I will tell you what this week's comic of the week question is. So, whatever you do, please do not go anywhere. This is Week 9 Now, here it is, your birthright.
There she is! My love, I come for you!
Nah, bro, this place has got Wi-Fi.
It's so fast.
Right?
Empire Shells is the same top-line brand name carpeting the stores in town will sell you. But you see, what they have to send away for, we have in stock, right in our warehouse. So you get it in 72 hours instead of 4 to 6 weeks. And don't forget, you also get your choice of a Bissell rug shampooer or a push-button telephone, absolutely free. Hey, you guys came to get me down, huh?
588-2300-EMPIRE.
Trevor, Scott, the boys, I am. Hey, boss. Hey, how come we never have celebrity guests on this program? Well, to be quite honest with you, Ed, I think that the celebrity guests that don't appear on this program because of the fact that the celebrities don't really care about this show. Wait a minute. What about Rebel Wilson Allen? He's a big celebrity. Yeah, but here's the thing. here's the thing. She married Tom Ellis. So that means that he is a fan of the show by association. Oh, yeah. You're right. You're right. I know. I know. It's just that we can't get some of the big-time celebrities on this program. Oh, I see. I see. Well, hopefully we'll have bigger celebrities sometime down the road. But, hey, we got Rebel Wilson Allen. That's a good thing. Yeah. Of course, we need bigger celebrities like Taylor Swift and things like that. You're right. You're right. You're right. Hey, let's watch another episode of Special Delivery. I'm cool with that. I'm cool with that, too. All right.
And now it's time for jokes with Mr. Comedy. Hey there, I am Mr. Comedy, and it is time for jokes. Yes, that's right, it is time for jokes with me, Mr. Comedy. And I have a good one that'll really make you laugh. Why was the skeleton by himself? Because he was feeling bonely. Until next time with jokes by me, Mr. Comedy. Goodbye.
That was incredible. And now, a performance from the Multiverse Disability Choir. And here's a little note. The performance that you are about to see and hear is for all the happy couples in the world.
An empty street, an empty house, a hole inside my heart. I'm all alone, the rooms are getting smaller. I wonder how, I wonder why, I wonder where they are. The days we had, the songs we sang together, oh yeah. And all my love, holding on forever, reaching for a love that seems so far. So I say a little prayer and hope my dreams will take me there, where the skies are blue, to see you once again, my love. Overseas from coast to coast, to find a place I love. Stop to keep myself from thinking, oh no. I wonder how, I wonder why, I wonder where they are. The days we had, the songs we sang together, oh yeah. And oh my love, I'm holding on forever, reaching for. Say a little prayer and hope my dreams will take.
Do you know what time it is? No, the Camel Lady, what time is it? Well, Rebel, it's time for A Moment for Everyone. I wonder what Ellie is going to say this time. Well, we're about to find out right now. Yeah, so take it away, Ellie. Yeah, Ellie. Love you, my smoochy poo.
Folks, as you know, we are rapidly approaching the end of September. I mean, think about it. Fall or autumn is about to begin this upcoming weekend. The kids are back from school. Parents are finding warm jackets for their kids. Talk show hosts like Kelly Clarkson and Drew Barrymore are coming back from their very long vacations. The leaves are changing colors and falling on the ground. And the stores have just sold their final batches of Halloween decorations. Yes, time is flying by. Now, listen to this. All right, when September ends in a couple of weeks, the stores will start getting Thanksgiving and Christmas decorations. And they'll start getting the Christmas gifts out too. Those things will let you know that 2024's days are about to be numbered. Now, while you think that it's too early to start thinking about the holiday season, let me tell you this, all right? Baby New Year grows up in a way that we don't. All right, on January 1st, Baby New Year was born. We all know that. But it starts walking and talking and eating solid foods after about 28 days. Then by the middle of February, Baby New Year turns into a big kid. By April 20th, that kid turns into a teenager. And it becomes Father Time by the middle of June. And then it looks a lot like Father Time by the time October rolls around. That's when everyone starts getting the holiday decorations and the holiday food ready to go. Because before you know it, another Baby New Year will be born and the cycle will begin again. Now, do you remember your plans for 2024? Do you want to accomplish? Some things in 2024. Well, time is running out for you. You only have until the last day of the year to get your 2024 to-do list finished. Actually, let's be honest. The holiday season can be all about fun and relaxation. So, you really have to get everything accomplished before the beginning of November. So let me help you out, all right? It's best to take care of the things that you can easily accomplish before the beginning of November. Because once November rolls around, everyone will start eating a lot, and everyone will start showing out a lot more. Alright, so, remember, if you want to accomplish some things this year, then you need to start with a really, really, really small goal. Alright, accomplish really, really, really small goal. Because I'll tell you, holiday season is right around the corner. Once the holiday season rolls around, that's it. It'll be too late to do anything big. All right? And also, so listen to me. Alright? If you have big goals planned, do me a huge favor. Push them toward 2025. Alright? Because, let's be honest, after the holidays, everything will begin to slow down a little bit. Alright? Because right now, everything is, rush. Alright? And I want you to rush to the big things and then redo everything on January 3rd. I mean, come on! Makes no sense. Now, let's have a little talking time, huh?
Hey, do you know what time it is? That's right, it's talkie time to know what he's going to talk about. So let's talk about it. Yee-hoo, baby!
James Gordon used to host a show on CBS called The Late Late Show, which followed The Late Show, before CBS decided to go on after midnight instead. Don't ask me why. I'm just telling you the truth. All right, now, listen to this, all right? He had a really bad experience with Rick Ross. James Gordon wanted to do a sketch with Rick Ross entitled Hustle. Well, actually, he wanted to do a sketch based on Rick Ross's hustling song. And he was told that Rick would love to participate in the sketch. Of course, participation proved a lot harder once he showed up. And Rick Ross stopped rehearsing just to go to the bathroom. He went to the bathroom and he never came back. Wow, that's just insane. Of course, you have to know what the celebrity guests want to do and what the celebrity guests do not want to do. Now, let's say if Taylor Swift ever wants to come on this show, then I would have to ask Taylor Swift questions that won't make her want to storm out. Because if Taylor Swift storms out or storms off, and you know that things aren't going well. You know what I'm saying? So, you have to understand what the celebrity guests want and don't want to do. Alright? Now, Lily Allen used to call James Gordon her big friend. That's right. And a bed friend is someone who wants sex but can't get any from anybody. That was back in 2008 when Lily Allen had her talk. Of course, several years later, one thing led to another, and that's when Lily Allen said, "You know what? I gotta cut ties with him." And that's what happened. Well, I have nothing left to say except, wow. Hey, you know what? Let's go over this week's comment of the week question. Yes, and it is a good one this week. Let me tell you. Do you think that an awkward person will ever become a great person? That's this week's comment of the week question. Do you think that an awkward person will ever become a great person? Do you think that an awkward person will ever become a great person? Go over to the community tab post and answer that question as honestly and as thoughtfully as you can. Now, folks, this episode of Week Up There is over, but a great week is just beginning. Tomorrow, we're going to deal with Amanda Seyfried. That's right. And on Wednesday, we're going to deal with Matt Davis. And on Thursday, we're going to talk about Soap. And then on Friday, we're going to talk about Olive. Now, it's also called Ball, but come on now. Work with me here. All right. Cavalier, the Cosby Crew, and ERMD, Dragon Ball Over 2004 will be here all week. And Gretchen Flakey's and Molly Talk will be here on Friday. Phew! That was a close one. I must say that this was the best episode of Week and Out Day ever. Well, that is it for another episode of Week and Out Day. I'll see you tomorrow night. That's news, and I am Outskies, 4x4.
And cut! That's a wrap! Great show, everybody! You all did a great job! Thanks, Ellie! Yeah, thanks! Until tomorrow's show, everybody! Okay! So, do you want to go for a movie or grab a steak?